The chairman of Lloyds Bank was by coincidence the man appointed to sort out the structure of Lloyds, the insurance market, no relation, in the light of its recent troubles. Today, his report recommended a slimmed-down ruling council and a separate, though internal, regulatory board. So Lloyds remains the only city market without a fully independent supervisory body, despite much criticism of previous efforts to police itself.
I think there has been a feeling of not wanting to hang too closely over the market, and it is a very difficult balance. You've got to be both streetwise and not interfering.
The scandals that provoked the regulatory self-examination were themselves the subject of another report released today. Sir David Walker, who used to be the city's overall regulator, looked specifically into charges of insider dealing. Although he found Lloyds insiders have done better than outside names, he found no evidence of fraud, just incompetence. His committee suggested a series of specific rule changes to dovetail with those of Sir Jeremy Morse. The Lloyds authorities declared themselves satisfied with the whole package.
The separation of regulation from the market will provide a better basis on which to develop the business and at the same time to ensure that regulation is effective.
But some market watchers say the new structure may not be strong enough.
The head of regulation will be an employee of the corporation and therefore ultimately answerable to the chief executive, and that seems possibly to subordinate the interests of regulation to that of business development.
And thousands of names who are planning to take legal action against their agents may find it easier to do so. Now the Walker report has ruled there was no criminality, just incompetence.
If it's fraud, then that's a criminal matter. If it's negligence, it's a civil matter, and therefore we can sue. We cannot sue in the case of fraud.
So will your members now be taking legal action then?
I think there's no question about that. No question.
It's clear neither of today's reports will do much to calm the immediate controversy and litigation surrounding Lloyds. In the longer term, if that means names continue to desert the market in their thousands, Lloyds' position as the world's leading insurance market could be severely undermined. This is David Strawn in the City for Thames News.